I'm impressed, very, very impressed.
I am a TripAdvisor fanatic.
A fanatic?
A fanatic. I go in depth. I'm going to put a little tiny dot. Do they change the sheets?
What happens if they don't change the sheets?
I won't come back.
From the comfort of their own homes, a growing band of armchair critics have been striking out using TripAdvisor, the world's largest travel review website.
Your starter for 10 is a horrible stain, and God only knows what that was.
My wife's lamb mint burger cost £15.50. She had 6 chips and I had 7.
But the owners of these put-upon businesses are fighting back.
John Cleese is an amazing hotel keeper in my eyes.
Oh, yes, we have arrived again!
It's all got out of control. TripAdvisor has become too big for its own boots.
With 120 hotels and restaurants going under each month, do the customers have too much power?
I am powerless to change what's been written about me. It's untrue and it's bullying.
Oh, here she is. Look at the way she's walking. She thinks she's important.
Oh, well, they all think they're important, don't they, these bastards?
Now, with tensions at an all-time high, some of the site's harshest critics are coming out from behind their screens to go head-to-head with beleaguered businesses.
Hello.
There's a percentage of you guys that are complete numpties.
You can't say that 50 million people are all bastards.
We're trying to please you today.
Right.
To get the review off. There's no agenda there.
I'm about that far away from going out there and kicking the bloody lot out. Hello, the Forge. Yes, I've got a room for tonight. Can you hold on a minute? I've just lost a dog. No, I haven't lost a dog. I thought I'd lost a dog, but I haven't. I'm in the middle of a field at the moment.
For the past 16 years, Colin Bowett has been running the Old Forge restaurant and B&B.
And what time do you think you'll be arriving? 10. OK, well, as long as I know. But if you say any later, I don't really want to be doing anything any later. It isn't a hotel. This is a bed and breakfast. It's our own home. So I don't really want to be standing about waiting for someone at midnight, to be quite honest.
Another booking, Colin?
Well, yes, tonight, but they have to be... Oh, I can't get there till 10. I don't know what time I should get there, and this, that and the other, and oh, dear. I mean, nobody seems to know what they're doing these days. I don't know. I couldn't run my life like that. Toto! Look at all those rabbits out there. Look, can you see them? Tiger seafood salad, go.
Every dish that comes out of the kitchen at the Old Forge is created and cooked by Colin.
Go. Wait! Work together. Right, go.
And he's also infamous for his forays into the dining room.
That's one of my inventions, and this one, and this particular one, you won't believe it, that's totally true. I dreamt about that in bed one day, and I got up and I cooked it for my lunch and I ate it. This is about 12 years ago, and it's been on the menu ever since.
Front of house at the restaurant, where the average main course costs £20, is Colin's wife, Sarah.
It's almost identical to 40 Towers here. Almost identical.
And, of course, I've been known when we've had Germans come in to go, oh, yes, we have arrived again! And, of course, that's wonderful, you see.
We've got a Spanish girl at the moment who can't speak a word of English, so we're trying to explain things to her, and she's going, ¿qué? 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 All the time.
What do I have for prawn cocktail? Do you know?
Yes, I know.
What?
The one crab, one lemon...
No, no, prawn cocktail is not a crab. Prawn cocktail.
Oh, I don't remember, sorry.
You don't remember.
Businesses like the Old Forge used to be inspected only once or twice a year by professional critics. But now, they're always being judged, as anyone can write a review on TripAdvisor. The Old Forge is not alone. 26 businesses are reviewed every minute on TripAdvisor, with an average score of 4 out of 5.
Up until recently, we've always been at the mercy of these businesses. They can treat us however they want, and we've got no comeback at all.
The satisfaction is not about pissing off the owner of an hotel. The satisfaction for me, the buzz for me, is about somebody else not making the mistake that I made, not wasting the money that I wasted, or, on the other side, enjoying what I enjoyed.
It is helpful that if you're making a comment about the hotel, that you back it up with some form of evidence. Tea and coffee making facilities are on the small cabinet because the socket is down here and the length of the lead is such that it won't reach up here. So you have to boil the water down here and then transport the kettle full of boiling water up here to actually make the drink.
Food totally average and eye-wateringly overpriced.
Every review of the Old Forge, good or bad, is scrutinised by Colin and Sarah.
The celebrity thing of coming out of the kitchen for praise, even more embarrassing. Completely delusional. All of our food was overcooked, very bland, the fish was watery. Horrible.
Yeah.
And why didn't they say anything on the night? We analyse it sometimes, or it causes an argument. Doesn't it? Because it actually makes me start to doubt whether we are doing the right thing.
In 1995, Colin and Sarah were driving past the Old Forge when they noticed it was for sale. They fell in love with it and sold their pub in Hertfordshire to finance the move.
When we bought this, we didn't have a lot of money. We had an old caravan out the back here, which nobody would have lived in, but we did. We lived in there for 2 years so we could let the rooms upstairs so that we could earn some money. Over the years, we've worked like mad to get this business how it is now. And then you get some bastard come in and say horrible things to us about this, that and the other. They haven't a clue what we've done or how we've...
How hard we work or how much
it affects us when someone gives you a kick in the teeth.
61-year-old Colin's been in the hospitality business since training as a chef when he was a teenager. But he almost had to give up working when he suffered a heart attack last year.
He was rushed off to hospital in the middle of the night and his heart stopped and I had to call an ambulance. So it's been very, very difficult. The doctors do say to him that he should try and avoid stress if he possibly can. I mean, it's impossible when you're cooking in a kitchen. But I think what they're trying to say is avoid the added stress, which is things like looking on the computer and seeing bad reviews and getting upset about them and then having an argument.
Avoiding the stress this weekend may prove hard, as one of their current guests is an avid user of TripAdvisor, retired policeman Gary Morgan.
Morning. How you doing?
Gary is staying as part of a short break with his best mate, George, who's still in bed after being ill in the night.
Would you like seniors?
Sorry?
Would you like seniors?
Seniors?
Seniors. Would you like
seniors? I understand what you're saying.
I said, would you like seniors?
Cereals, please. Sorry. Yeah.
Can you help yourself?
Yes, I will do. Thank you. Sorry.
How are you this morning?
I'm marvellous. Every day's a good day, don't forget that. We're all here.
George is upstairs. He's had a bit of a funny night. He had a bit of a dodgy tummy overnight.
You took it the night before. It was heated up in the microwave. It's absolutely as simple as that. Not many people know that.
Does it taste the same?
It tastes just as good, if not better.
Isn't it all a bit soggy?
No.
Hi.
Am I late?
A little bit,
as usual.
No worries. Fashionably late.
I think I ate too much fish. I've never eaten that much fish in my life. And by 5:30, I had pains in my stomach at 10:30, so I went to bed.
Is this chap complaining? Is this chap saying that he's not very well? But it's not the food. They had 10 Budweisers last night, and then they went up to the pub afterwards. Nothing to do with us. Not our fault.
I didn't even have a lot to drink, did I? I had a couple of bottles of beer.
Yeah, 2 bottles of beer.
Gary's review of the Old Forge has just been posted on TripAdvisor. Colin, Sarah and their 11-year-old daughter, Georgie, gather to hear the verdict.
Colin told me that £65 per night for a B&B in this particular region of Norfolk is competitively priced.
He didn't pay £65, he paid £55. So he wants to get his bloody facts right before he starts writing rubbish.
Breakfast was an offering of cereals, freshly pressed orange juice and a full English breakfast. The plate was lightly spattered in oil due to serving from a really hot frying pan.
Bollocks. I cleaned that plate because I actually cooked that myself.
My friend had eaten so much the night before that he had actually been sick in the night.
This is a what they call a bullshit review. Full of bullshit by a chap that knows bugger all about anything, I should think.
It affects Colin and I really badly. We end up talking about these reviews and it's the wrong time, usually late at night, and it usually ends up in an argument.
Anybody that's reading that, they can say, oh, that's nice, that's the... Oh, but he was sick at the end of it, so we're not going there, he's sick. He's obviously sick because he's had too much to bloody drink, and I get it in the bloody back for it. But it's not on, it's not right.
I don't think people realise, actually, what it does to us. I didn't mean to do this, sorry.
I think the word is little Hitlers. And that's the word I've been looking for all the time. We've got little Hitlers all the way around the bloody country.
Oh, I wouldn't want to carry on like this. No.
They think they can just walk over anybody. Well, they ain't walking over me and they ain't walking over my wife.
Awful, awful, awful place. That was a shithole. Disgusting rip-off. Reservation cancelled, left roomless at night.
Stuart Wilson is one of TripAdvisor's more candid reviewers.
Another one here. Absolute shithole. I can't believe people stay there. I think all businesses should be held accountable and I think they should all deliver what they say. And it's that satisfaction. Yeah, you've been shafting tourists like me for years.
Mature student Stuart has spent the last 6 years travelling the world, racking up hundreds of TripAdvisor reviews.
I'm a great believer in freedom of speech, particularly if you provide a service or a product, I think everybody's got a right to comment on that, to give their opinion.
For his next stay, Stuart has his sights set on the Eltamere Inn in the Lake District.
Faulty Towers setting is wonderful, but the owner is so arrogant and intimidating. There's another one here, arrogant, greedy and not caring. Seems like a bit of a dick, right? But we'll see, won't we?
As a passionate defender of the consumer cause, he'll be breaking cover and letting the hotel see his review before he checks out.
I think your fire precaution is all wrong. There's no notice in the room saying what to do in the event.
Well, there is no fire. I get very fiery at times because things get under your collar, don't they? Things upset you. They flash, but that's what it's doing.
I can see that flash when I've got my eyes shut in bed.
I actually don't want to be that nasty, horrible Basil Fawlty type of character.
So
I think you're slightly overreacting, really, because it's only been in for 6 months. But unfortunately, if somebody does upset me or a member of my staff, then the old Basil button does get pressed, and I can kick off.
Mark Jones bought the Eltamere Inn 2 years ago. He embarked on a complete renovation, stamping his unique taste all over it.
It is part of you. This is an extension of me, of my wife. It's our style.
Mark's particular style of management and choice of interior design have attracted lots of comments on TripAdvisor.
I actually quite enjoy taxidermy. I wouldn't have it in my own home. I would never dream of shooting a tiger, but somebody did once, and I've got it, and I like it, and it's in my bar.
I'm more than willing to step out of the shadows. You've got to be honest with these guys, so you've got to tell them what you really think. I am expecting a really nice place. Well, there's some guy that's up his own ass.
I really don't know what to expect I guess my initial impression would be the car he's driving. If a big posh Jag pulls up, chances are we'll get on. But if a beaten-up Corsa comes on with a very bad personalised reg, then the chances are that, you know, we won't get on. It'll be a strained relationship for 24 hours.
Thinking I was about right.
Oh, hi, welcome.
Okay.
And this is?
This is Andy.
Andy is your mate, is he?
Yeah, friend. Okay. Yeah.
Goody good. There's the notorious Chatterley collection that's remarked upon constantly. Some people ask me to remove it, others are quite happy with it.
Do you get many families?
Pardon?
Many families.
We don't do a lot of families, so it's not too bad, really. That's another stuffed beastie.
Did you shoot that?
No, but I know the man that did. This is normally a big double bed, but because you're two chaps, we've made it into a twin for you.
Thank you. Mark, okay. Yeah?
Mark, yeah.
Cheers, Mark.
Cheers, Stu.
Surely when you get out of the bath, you're just going to drip all over the floor and he's going to fucking bill you for it. What do you reckon? You wet my carpet. No shit. There's no fucking mat. If he's got any common sense, he will be on his best behaviour. But can he hold it all day till tomorrow? We'll see. It's all got out of control. TripAdvisor has become too big for its own boots.
They smile to your face, tell you what a wonderful time they've had, and then get home and stick the knife in.
A main issue I've got with TripAdvisor is that actually anybody can review my hotel. I could even review my own hotel if I don't get caught.
One reviewer on TripAdvisor has a greater eye for detail than any other.
Keep away from the camels altogether, as they can wee on people at any moment. No detail is too small. Do you want to get weed on by a camel? No, you don't, especially in hot weather.
Here we go, Dovedale.
26-year-old supermarket manager Ricky has brought his grandma for a weekend in Cleethorpes.
It looks nice.
It does, doesn't it? Ooh. I tell you what, I'm liking them curtains.
Yes.
Them curtains are very nice. Is it a walk-in shower?
Yes.
Fantastic. I'm impressed, very, very impressed. I am a TripAdvisor fanatic.
A fanatic?
A fanatic. I go in depth to everything.
How in depth do you know?
Interior, exterior, what the food was like, what the staff was like.
He's always phoning me up. Nana, I've just done this review.
Food on a plane, service on the plane, entertainment on the plane.
He reads it out to me over the phone. You know, I'm there with the phone, you know, going, yeah, Rick, oh, that's good, Richard, yeah.
What there is to do for children and to all different age groups.
Have you got children?
I haven't got children. No, but other people have children. Wow. Green is my favourite colour. As well. That's absolutely gorgeous.
For Ricky, even the most perfect of rooms needs to be put through its paces.
Are they replenishing what's free within the room? I'll make it look like I've had one. Two milk, one coffee, a white sugar and a Tetley tea bag. I'm going to put a little tiny dot. We're checking housekeeping standards. Do they change the sheets? That is the dot. Very, 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 very tiny.
What happens if they don't change the sheets?
I won't come back.
Even though you love the room?
Love the room, but my skin. My skin will flake, unfortunately, in this bed, and I can't go back into it. It's like a Hawaiian. And people with the shirts off playing ball like that.
What do you think it's better?
It's better than Blackpool.
Back from a day out, Ricky's keen to see whether housekeeping has passed his tests.
Shaking a little bit. The adrenaline rushing through me. I'm fine. They haven't replenished the tea and coffee. And the dot is still there.
Do you think you're being fair to the hotel?
Sometimes, well, if it's weird, it's weird to, I mean, I've got a skin condition. Why should I tell them about my skin condition? They should really be asking me the question, is everything okay? Do you need any extra requirements in the room?
While some TripAdvisor reviews may seem trivial, the impact on businesses can be serious. At a time when more than 120 hotels and restaurants are going under every month.
Thank you. I've got the vodka and tonic.
Vodka and lemonade it was.
Oh, sorry about that. Back. There's your brandy and diet. Can you be right back? Sorry.
Okay, it's all right.
Brandy and
the... Oh, dear.
What happened?
I asked for a vodka and lemonade and they brought a vodka and tonic. I am going to put that in review, in my review.
If I asked for a vodka and tonic, vodka and lemonade, and they brought me a vodka and tonic, yeah, I'd say, Luke, you brought me the wrong drink, do you mind changing it?
Yeah.
But I wouldn't make an issue of it.
I'm not making an issue of it.
Well, what are you doing then?
I'm going to, on TripAdvisor, I'm going to say I asked for something, they got it wrong.
Right.
They rectified it very, very quickly.
Why do you need to write about it?
Because it's an experience which I've encountered. And TripAdvisor is all about reviewing instances which have happened on your holiday.
Yeah, but not a petty thing like bring it wrong drink. I love him to bits, but he is enjoying that power. When he was gone to school, like, he was bullied and so forth. And, I mean, he seems to think now that he is getting the upper hand of certain people kind of thing. And he's enjoying it.
I've gone through life with people telling me that I'm not good enough, you've not got any good qualifications. And in the past, it's upset me. It's really, really upset me.
Take that one again.
Everybody has got something that they're good at.
Yes, bro.
And I am good at writing reviews and reviewing destinations and helping people.
Most businesses never know when there's a reviewer in their midst. But at the Eltimere Inn, owner Mark Jones has just had a TripAdvisor to stay.
Right, let's print off this review.
Stuart Wilson is one of the site's harshest critics and biggest advocates. He's written a review telling Mark exactly what he thinks of him and his hotel.
Goodness gracious. Hi, chaps.
You all right?
Yeah, good, thanks.
I just think that some of it's a little bit tasteless. And I think, as a reviewer on TripAdvisor, it's my job to let other people know of that. Not necessarily what offends me, but what might possibly offend other people, like the pictures on the wall, for example.
I even quite like the swinger bit, you know? I mean, it's...
Do you agree?
Well, I don't agree.
Obviously.
I don't actually agree with that, but I do find it amusing.
You seem to be embracing that review. So you say, well, you know, don't like TripAdvisor. But yet you're embracing it, and that's what I really think you should do. You're always going to get pricks. You're going to get prick hotel managers. You're going to get prick reviewers. It's what's going to happen. But the fact is, you're just going to have to embrace it, I believe.
I actually have a lot of pride in what I've created, and there is a certain element of people out there that will come and try and knock it down. I think we're very professional in our way, OK?
But your response is not professional.
But that's debatable, isn't it? I mean, I'd just like to inject
a
little bit of fun into it.
Humour and fun, get that. Personal insults and firing back insults, you surely, as a hotel manager, people would expect you to rise above it. Because someone calls you arrogant, you'll leave a response that is wholly arrogant.
There's a trench of society that is now becoming the review culture. They go home and they get off on writing bad reviews. They will come in and they'll nitpick and tell the world that I wasn't happy.
But they have got that right.
What I'm saying is there's a percentage of you guys out there that are complete and total numpties who have got no idea how damaging it is.
You can't say that 50 million people are all bastards.
No, I'm not saying that.
You know.
No, absolutely. Listen, I'm not saying that 50 million people are absolute bastards. 100,000 of them are.
A guest has had a little bit of a mishap and wet the bed. So basically, I'm putting on clean sheets.
More than 85,000 British businesses have been assessed on TripAdvisor, including the Holly's Guest House.
Is this a frequent occurrence?
It happens with little kids. Sometimes it happens with adults as well, if they've been out the night before and just, I don't know, I guess they forgot to go to the toilet before they fell asleep or something like that.
The B&B is run by Bev Trodd, her 14-year-old daughter, Georgia, and her husband, Ian.
Are you all right? Ready for the wedding?
The worst things are vomiting in the sink and just left there for us to clear up. We do have to take people to one side and have to explain to them that their behaviour is not appropriate or acceptable. And that's when the knife comes out. They are straight onto TripAdvisor. Sometimes they've actually loaded a TripAdvisor report before they've even left the B&B.
It's a very personal, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Because they're my family and we all work here. This is our job and it's our home. Sorry, I'm getting really emotional and I don't know why.
The Hollies is about to receive another visit from a TripAdvisor, church historian John and his partner Sean.
OK, I'll see you up there in a minute.
OK.
With more than 200 posts on TripAdvisor, John's one of Britain's most hard-working reviewers, and he knows he's part of a long line of amateur critics.
Right, I've got a collection of diaries which date back to the 19th century, and this diary is a man called William Wigston. In 1833, he travelled across the country and he said that he reluctantly returned to the New Inn, where we slept at this house with second-rate fare, and we were charged at least 20% higher than at the Swan Inn at Bedford. So, you know, even 200 years ago, people were commenting on the quality of accommodation. TripAdvisor is extremely addictive. You know, I don't go anywhere now without using it. And even when I'm not looking at it for inspiration as to where to stay, I'm looking at it for fun.
I got this picture out for you because I wanted to show it to you. It's a picture of me on holiday in St Ives when I was 12. That was the day that I decided I was going to come to St Ives and run a B&B. There are things now that have taken the shine off of my dream. Yeah, yeah.
What are those things?
Well, TripAdvisor.
It's tall, isn't it?
It is.
Granite, stone and nice gravel garden, easy to maintain.
To actually come face to face with somebody who goes on TripAdvisor is actually quite cathartic, really. Hello, welcome.
Hello, I'm John.
Hi, John. And you're
Hello
Sean?
There. I'm Sean. Very
Hello,
nice to
Sean,
meet you.
And you too.
John and Sean are staying in a room costing £90 per night in high season.
Actually, before we start messing the room up, you know what we've
Picture.
Got to do. Right, so we take it from here. Shall we get most of the room in?
Yeah.
It's a bit difficult because it's not a huge room, is it?
Yep.
And shall we go and have a look at the bathroom now? Let's see if the fan stays on. One of the worst things is when you're going to the bathroom at night and you've had to put the light on, you turn it off again and there the fan's running, and we'll have to keep an eye on that and see how long that goes on for. so you can hear that, can't you?
Annoying.
It is a bit annoying if it's going to carry on for a long time.
Oh. That is vile. All the attention to detail in the room, freshly decorated, and a dirty toilet brush.
How about the kettle? Because you know what I'm like about kettles. Ah, Sean, look. There is water in that in the kettle. You better change that before we start.
Customers are now expecting a bijou hotel with all the luxury that goes with that, but at B&B prices.
While Bev's latest guests are settling in, another review of the Hollies has just been posted.
Bev spoke to us like we were excretion.
It's from a guest she had an argument with.
Room 9 of the Hollies is cramped, old, smelly hovel. We were also yelled at for a minuscule amount of sand that we brought in from the beach, and Bev was constantly speaking to us like we were something she had trod in.
Why do you let it upset you so much, Bev?
Because it's untrue, and there's nothing I can do about it. I am powerless to change what's been written about me. It's untrue and it's bullying. I am basically being bullied. That's why I'm so angry about it, because I am totally powerless. TripAdvisor allow this to happen, and I am powerless to change it. What can I do about that?
Bev can post a response to the review, or she can try to persuade TripAdvisor or the critic to take it down.
This is Bev from the Hollies in St Ives. I wanted to discuss... Oh, there we are. That's a response. She's put the phone down on me. So there you go. It's not really working, is it?
As you can see, we're serving rubbish tonight, as usual. I'm sure everybody will hate it.
At the Old Forge, the dust has settled on the last TripAdvisor visit. But there's one review that Colin can't forget.
We ate wonderful seafood in some great places. However, the Old Forge was not one of them. My overwhelming impression was of mounds of seafood piled onto plates and swamped in sauces, the seafood itself being overcooked and inedible. The sauces were heavy-handed and lacking finesse. None of our group could finish our main dishes, and we paid the bill and hurried out.
My wife said, "Oh, we got a review," because evidently it flashes up. I'm not a computer man. I'm a heavy-handed cook, evidently, according to this woman.
Catherine, who's studying a master's in design, has been a TripAdvisor for the past 5 years.
I'm a fair reviewer. I try to keep things balanced, even if I don't have a great experience.
She picked the Old Forge as a birthday treat for her partner.
We were kind of like going over it and had agreed by the end of the weekend that that was the worst dining experience we'd had and that people needed to know about it.
It's like a kick in the teeth. It's probably like if she likes going to the beautician, as women do. She comes out of the beautician, I say, "Oh, Christ, you look bloody ugly." Well, I wonder how she would feel.
In response to the review, Colin has extended an offer to Catherine.
We've asked the lady to come back, or the woman. I don't know whether she's a woman or a lady, but she at the moment, she thinks she's a lady, and I think she's a woman. Can you get me that lobster? I want her to have a nice meal, and perhaps she can remove this horrible thing that she's put on.
If a business is unhappy with a review, they can write a management response, as the Old Forge did for the one-star review by Catherine.
We have been trading successfully for 15 years. If we are as bad as you claim, we would have gone bust years ago. It would be much nicer to spend your time raising money for terminally ill children. These guys are idiots. Okay.
In St Ives, avid TripAdvisor John is on holiday with his partner, Sean. He's writing a review of the Hollies guest house, where it's almost bedtime.
It might be a problem that this window hasn't got a curtain on it. That's why we're going to put the lights out and have a look. Do you think you're going to be able to sleep with that light coming onto your bed?
I think so. But it's the flashing of the security light from the building opposite.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Is it that bad?
Yeah, it's flashing. It really is very bright indeed. This lack of curtain on this window is, I'm afraid, a major point. I want to be absolutely fair with this review, but at the moment it's not looking very good.
After a fitful night's sleep, John's posted his review. He's awarded the Hollies 3 stars in a write-up entitled A Pleasant Stay, But... Downstairs, owner Bev's reading the review before they check out.
Hello.
Hello.
It's only me. For that light out there, other than leaping over the wall and smashing it off the wall, I can't do anything about it.
No, you could put a blackout up at this window.
Yeah, yeah. What, until such times as he changes his bulb?
It's not just your neighbour's lights, it's natural light as well.
Yeah, OK. I would have really, really appreciated you coming to say to me, Bev, that loo brush in there's got mist, or... Do you think you could empty the kettle for me?
Just a dirty loo brush or old water in the kettle. I'm not going to bother you about that.
But I'd rather be bothered about it than it going on TripAdvisor. That's what we're here for, this service industry.
Yeah, but then the upshot of that is that hopefully you will now think to check these things.
Yeah.
And so somebody in the future won't write it on TripAdvisor. So it's actually fulfilled its purpose, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has, but it still upset me.
Bye-bye now.
If TripAdvisor really do believe that it is being used in the way that they set it up, then they are absolutely fucking naive, because it isn't being used in the way it was meant to be used.
The power struggle between reviewers and businesses on TripAdvisor is about to come to a head in Norfolk. Sarah and Colin are preparing for a visit from a critic who left a 1-star review of their restaurant and are hoping to convince her to remove the damaging post. Catherine is returning to the Old Forge with her partner Ian and friend Kate.
Oh, here she is. Oh, my God.
Is she big and fat?
Oh, she looks the way she walks. No, just the way she's walking.
Have a look at the bloody woman.
Look at the way she's walking. No, mind, I've got to go and see
her. Is that the skinny woman?
Yeah.
Oh,
did you see the way
God's
she was
sake.
Walking just there?
No, I didn't.
She's really important. Do you think she's important?
Oh, well, they all think they're fucking important, don't they, these bastards?
Hello, hi. Do you want to come through?
Yes.
I'll sit you at your table.
Thank you.
Are you nervous, Colin?
No, I couldn't give a fuck about the woman. I honestly couldn't. The trouble is, she might do damage to our business yet again.
Colin's done a special menu for you. After the meal, we're just going to have a little chat about the review.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Yeah? Because we'd just like to sort of just clear up a few points that we were probably a little bit upset about.
Okay.
So, have your meal and enjoy yourselves anyway. That's the most important thing.
Yeah,
and then
we'll
have a little chat afterwards.
Okay.
The wine's
nice.
Good choice.
Mm.
And it's really hot
here, making fun. How do you feel
about the food? Yeah, I think the food's good. You know, within reason.
Mm. I don't know about the
are you all okay?
Yeah.
It's
good.
Did you enjoy it?
I did.
Thank
yeah,
you.
Fish was lovely.
Oh, good. Please, you enjoyed it.
I like the cooking.
That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to please you today.
Great.
To get the review off. So we want to please.
I can imagine her writing shitty reviews. I'll start getting a bit. Now I'm being too nice.
Did you like Norfolk when
I
you came?
I love Norfolk. It's beautiful.
Yeah. The winter in Norfolk's lovely. Mm. We prefer it in the winter to the summer.
Okay.
Yeah, no, you get a lot of... In the summer, you don't get very nice people.
Mm. Really?
Oh, yeah. Big difference. Yeah.
We've been in all seasons. And I think in the autumn, it was really beautiful.
Well,
it's stunning.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. It's, winter's the best, though, definitely. You got plum crumble now.
Thank you. No agenda there.
Yeah.
There's no way she's going to take that review off. Yeah. I can tell she's a bitch
underneath
it. For life,
that's going to be there for life. You know, that's going to be. You know, you can get murder and get 30 years and come out of bloody come out of prison, but this TripAdvisor stays there for life, and we haven't murdered anybody. It's absolutely ridiculous. Shall I give you a cuddle? Hmm. Yeah. Well done.
I'm tired as well.
I know.
But put all that effort in to make them nice.
Yeah.
Try and make them nice, and they're horrible.
Yeah. It makes me feel now I'm about that far away from going out there and kicking the bloody lot out.
After lunch at the Old Forge...
Hello.
Hello.
Colin and Sarah want to talk to Catherine about removing her old review.
We have a sprinkling of customers. Sorry, you've got the best legs in Norfolk in front of you. You might not like the food, but the legs are amazing, so I'm told.
Catherine's partner Ian and her friend Kate were also present at the original meal.
You've had some lunch today.
Yeah.
How was that?
That was nice.
Thank
yeah.
God for that.
Thank you.
Nice hospitality.
But I thought,
this game
was lovely. Well, I'm pleased that you're here, and I'm pleased that we're trying to get you on our side, I suppose. I don't know if it's possible to, though, because I
don't know. You should have to.
Well, I run a restaurant. I have to try and get people on my side because there's an awful lot of people that come in these days that aren't very friendly, so I have to try and make them.
They're not, as soon as they were, before they walk
before
through
they
the door,
even eat
not,
the food.
Not
so, you
well,
know.
You know, you can't. Yeah.
Well, no, it's a fact, you know, that we're not trying to hide it. It's a fact, people are not as friendly, and they're not as well-mannered as they used to be.
That's got nothing to do with us.
When I read the review, I was very upset, and I don't like to think that we've upset people with our food or our hospitality.
You shouldn't necessarily have to please all the people all the time, you know. I know it's difficult.
Well, we try to. No, hang on, we try to.
Nobody likes to get any... That's our job.
It's all right you saying you shouldn't try to please the people all the time. I totally disagree with that. I've been in this business for 46 years. I've been in this business for 46 years. Sorry, I've just had open heart surgery and I'm on a lot of drugs. So please don't laugh at my thing that I'm doing. Yes, we do look after everybody as best we possibly can, with humour. And with niceness.
Yeah.
When something like this comes through and my wife reads it out to me, I feel hurt. I feel that it's very, very unkind because I'm a nice person and I work with passion. I'm 61 years of age. I want to carry on because I love doing what I do and I love my family and I want to provide for my family. This is a family business.
We stop filming.
I find this really inappropriate, I'm afraid.
Stop.
I've had enough. Thank you for your hospitality.
Yeah,
I really enjoyed the meal.
We're quite happy. Yeah.
It's very unfair for you to just get up and walk away. It's bullshit.
I've had enough of it now.
It's bullshit.
It hasn't been very successful.
It might have been, I don't know.
No.
Who knows?
I don't understand why they got so... what they're so upset about. The review was beyond me, and now their behaviour here is beyond me.
After a break in filming, Catherine and Ian agreed to continue to defend their use of TripAdvisor.
I think any customer buying a service has a right to review the service that they receive. And you don't have to address, you know, the issues there and then. You know, you may not feel that's appropriate.
That's the way of the world. But I don't know how to put this without upsetting anybody.
Okay.
Or myself.
Done. Yeah.
I just wanted to mention about...
Sorry, turn it off.
It's very easy for her to go off
write her review, maybe after a couple of glasses of wine, because she's sitting in her little office or whatever on her computer. But it's not so easy for her to come back here and then meet me personally. TripAdvisor definitely makes it easier for people to go away and be vindictive and nasty about people.
TripAdvisor has revolutionised the way that we travel, giving the consumer a voice. But now Britain's small hotels and restaurants must decide whether they want to continue at a time when everyone's a critic.
If we carry on getting these sort of nasty reviews from various people, I think probably we would seriously consider about closing up and moving on.
Being a good Christian man, I always think of what the good Lord said when he was on the cross. Because it feels as though you're on the cross sometimes in this trade. And he said, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
I don't really consider the business owner when I make a TripAdvisor review, because it's not about friendship, it's about business. They're making money out of you, it is a business.
I hope that it encourages small businesses to improve what they do to the benefit of us all.
I have got to the point where I've considered trying to find somebody that could hack that site and crash it. That's how bad it's called. It's caused me absolute heartache and heartbreak.
Next week, we go all the way to Zambia. When a hippo dies, find out what happens to it as it forms part of the food chain in the wild. Monday at 9. Next tonight, the good, the bad, jealousy and betrayal. A gripping brand new drama this week is about to erupt in a London estate. Top Boy.